We are counting down the hours until kickoff at Stadium Australia for the semi-final of the Women's World Cup. Our Matildas are preparing to take on England for a spot in the final this weekend. 10 News First reporter Taylor Ryan has the latest.
We're just hours away from kickoff for tonight's semi-final, and if our Matildas are feeling any of the pressure, they're certainly not showing any sign of it just yet. A smiling Mary Fowler and a relaxed-looking Steph Catley, Hayley Raso, alongside our goalkeeper Mackenzie Arnold, were all spotted on early coffee runs this morning ahead of their clash with England later tonight. The team is supported by their loyal family and friends here in Sydney. No one is prouder, of course, than the parents of our star footballers. And Emily van Egmond's father, Gary, a former coach himself, spoke to the media a short time ago about how the girls are feeling.
For them to be in a position where they've got, you know, this amount of support, they're not used to it, but they're very much welcoming it. These opportunities don't come around too often, so you've got to take You've got to take it while you can.
It's a drizzly, cold morning here in Sydney today, but the skies should clear in time for kickoff. With Stadium Australia sold out tonight, it will be filled to the brim with passionate Matildas fans hoping to see our national heroes make history and make that final against Spain to be held this weekend.
Taylor Ryan there. Yes, millions around the nation are ready to glue themselves to a screen. They've spent the last few days, the Matildas that is, in Sydney prepping, all under the watchful eye of a woman who's experienced it all before, Matildas alumni Alicia Ferguson. Alicia, thanks for joining us at midday. Now, as head of delegation, you make sure the Matildas' every need is granted. So how are they today?
They're good. I say this. They've just got this calm confidence about them. Mm. You know, these game days, they're pretty quiet. They get a bit of treatment. They go out for a walk. They catch up with friends and family and they just rest and prepare. You know, it's a later kickoff, so there's probably a bit of an afternoon napping going on there at some point, but they're ready to go.
Now, millions of Australians are experiencing this for the first time, and for some of us, the nerves of watching the penalty shootout is just too much to handle. But these players are used to it. They eat this pressure for breakfast because of the experience I've got overseas. So is this unusual for them at all?
No, it's not. And I think this is the great thing about now that they're within, like, you know, 10 years of being professionals now. Mm. And so what they do, say, for example, someone like a Sam Kerr, she's on a WSL side, Women's Super League side Chelsea on a Sunday. Then she's got to play a Champions League game on a Wednesday and then she's got to back it up with another game on a Sunday. So they're used to it. They're used to resetting and preparing and resting and recovering and getting themselves ready to play every two or three days.
And they're used to the jet lag. A lot of the other teams have come from quite a long way away and they've had to get used to being in Australia and recovery time. So are the Matildas like, see what we've been telling you all this time?
You know what? It's nice to get a little bit back of all these players because, you know, our players are actually they're the most travelled players. We've got a 24-hour flight back here, so it's nice to drag everyone else into the jet lag. I can speak from dealing with them from last year. You know, it's still tough to get over and to recover from that, but they've been in camp for about 9 weeks now together. So they're all ready to go. Nothing like, you know, hanging around each other for 9 weeks. They're pretty much, it's a family atmosphere. It's just as I say, there's just this calmness about them in camp.
And is that a reflection of the club, Football Australia, the people that are around them, keeping them grounded and keeping out the noise, I guess?
Yeah, and I guess that's a part of one of my roles as well, is to kind of make sure that the outside noise stays as the outside noise. And Tony Gustafsson uses the circle analogy a lot with this team. So we need to keep focusing inward. And the team does that very, very well. And we've done well with protecting them, and they've been in their bubble, and I think that's working great for them. I think they, look, I would say to the fans, they see you, they definitely hear you, and they feel the energy, but they just need to kind of separate that for the time being and focus on the job at hand.
I think some of the really heartwarming moments on their socials in particular, by the way, over 500,000 followers on Instagram now. Well, I think Angela Bishop set a challenge to get to 1 million by the end of today, so hopefully, fingers crossed. But some of the beautiful moments are seeing the little kids at camp, the players' kids. I mean, that's gorgeous.
Yeah, so Katrina Gorrie has little Harper, who basically has 22 aunties just fawning to her every need.
It's like, her birthday today.
It is her birthday today, yeah. Happy birthday, Harper, wherever you are. Happy birthday. Her second birthday. Look, and also Tamiki Yallop with her daughter Harley and her partner Kirsty, and It actually brings a really nice vibe because it actually also brings the human side of what sport and what athletes have to go through. You know, Katrina's still got to be a mum after 90 minutes or 120 minutes and a penalty shootout at football as well. And I think it just helps everyone reset up to what's really important, and it is that family value system.
You mentioned 10 years of being professional. What does that mean? For a lot of us, we've just come on board, you know, bandwagon is a term that's been used a lot, but that's okay. We can all jump on whenever we like. But this has been a long time in the making to have this sort of momentum that we experience now.
Yep, it's what we've always wanted as women. We want to take away the gender bias. Mm. That's what we want to do. And all we want is that equity amongst men and women. And I think it's great seeing the professionalism. These girls are now compensated appropriately for being professional athletes. And I think that's exactly what we need. And I think you can tell that in what the product and the football, it's entertaining, it's absolute quality. And these women are just amazing role models. I say this, the diversity of the demographic of fans at these games, because it's not just marketed to the young girls and the women anymore. There's the men, there's the, you know, the boys, everyone is on board with the Matildas. Mm. And again, that's what we wanted to take away, that gender bias.
I think it's great when, if you watch it in a pub or a restaurant, you see the gruff kind of blokes with their arms crossed at the beginning of the game. By the end of it, they're on their feet as well. And another interesting thing I heard from FIFA was the stats on stadiums, how non-alcoholic drinks are now being bought more than alcoholic drinks. So it's really redefining how we watch sport and how we enjoy sport.
Sounds weird in Australia though, doesn't it? I'm a bit surprised by that. Yeah, look, that's it. But look, and I've heard this, and sometimes the men's side of sport can maybe have a bit more testosterone and aggression, whereas the viewing environment and the actual match day experience for women's sport, I think, is what's really drawing in fans and really drawing in the excitement of it. But you just see the quality of the football on show is exceptional. I noticed it at the Euros last year, and this World Cup has exceeded expectations.
Now, there might be pay parity for the Matildas, but what about in terms of prize money from FIFA?
Yeah, they're still working on that.
Because we're a quarter of what the men...
They are, but look, it's all built into commercial deals, it's all built into broadcast deals, and that's where we need to keep pushing and pushing with our commercial partners, our brand partnerships, and also broadcast deals. But, you know, you get people to the stadium, you get people watching the game, and then the broadcasters will come and they'll want to pay more money for it, which means the sponsors will get more eyeballs on it. So it's a knock-on effect, but I think this has been a really strong... example of how much potential there is.
Yes, so much potential. All the way to the final on Sunday. Alicia Ferguson, thanks so much for joining us. Really appreciate your time on Midday.